Hello students, welcome to AC Engineering. And this is a video which is going to describe you about an engineering practices lab electrical fourth experiment titled Measurement of Voltage, Current, Power and Power Factor using R load. For doing an experiment and understanding this experiment, you definitely knew the wattmeter connections. How to make a wattmeter connection, how to measure an wattmeter reading and everything given in a separate video. The description box gives you the video link. So before entering into this explanation of this experiment, you kindly be refer and previous video for wattmeter connections, then only it is easier for you to understand. So the main objective of this experiment is simply to measure a voltage, current, power and power factor of a given circuit when it is connected with an R load. So in order to measure an voltage, we need voltmeter. In order to measure a current, we need ammeter. For measuring a wattmeter, we are in need of an wattmeter, and power factor is going to be calculated using a formula. So this is what our objective. For an AC circuit, so that we need an voltmeter in MI type, a moving ion type. Hopefully everybody knew the concepts behind. For an AC measurement, we are in need of moving ion meter. For an DC measurement, we need moving coil meter. Voltmeter in the ranges of 300 volt. Why? Because our given supply voltage single phase is 230 volt. So the rounding off and value in a meter reading availability is only 300 volt. That's why we have chosen 0 to 300 volt MI meter. And the current also 10 amperes maximum, so that ammeter also chosen in the range of 0 to 10 ampere. For an AC current measurement, MI moving ion meter is chosen. Then wattmeter. You are all well aware that how to write the wattmeter readings. It's given in a previous video. Link given in a description box. Refer it. So the voltage rating of a wattmeter is 300 volt. Current rating 10 amps. And then power factor is unity power factor, because the load connected in the given circuit is an R load, resistive load. So the load requirement is only resistive load. And then necessary connecting wires. We'll go through the procedure. So below referred a circuit diagram. I will show you the circuit diagram later. So connections were made as per the circuit diagram. Initially load is applied. No load condition means none of the load is applied. Then here we are using a special arrangement of an auto transformer. Why the auto transformer is to give an voltage from minimum to maximum 230 volt. So in not even going to inrush the applied voltage, we are giving it's a gradual way. So for giving a gradual increase in voltage, we are in need of an auto transformer here. Then rated voltage by using an auto transformer 230 volt is set up. Then measure and record the values of voltmeter, ammeter, wattmeter under no load condition. So for making a wattmeter calculation, definitely you have to aware of the multiplication factor of the wattmeter and what is given, and you have to mention everything in a tabular column, make an calculations. Fine. So for the cases of a wattmeter, you need two readings. One observed reading as it is from a wattmeter, and second reading is an actual reading. Actual reading meant it as observed reading into multiplication factor. Observed reading into multiplication factor. So multiplication factor is given in wattmeters by the manufacturer. Manufacturer itself, he specified the multiplication factor. So we have to use the same multiplication factor. Along with an observed reading, we need to calculate the actual wattmeter reading. These are all the things we have to make it with a no load condition. Then just apply the load gradually. with an application of unload, again repeat the same procedure of calculating and means absorbing voltmeter, ammeter and wattmeter reading. So up to what constraint we have to make an observation? So simply increase the load one by one, increase the load one by one up to when your ammeter reaches 10 amps. So up to 10 amps of current value, you have to make an increase in load, one load, say two load, three load, four load. You have to make an increase of load. Until then, if it your ammeter reads and 10 amps, no need to go for beyond the value. So you have to set right up to 10 amps of reading. After taking all the readings, reduce the load slowly, switch off loads one by one, and bring the auto transformer to the minimum position and switch off the supply. Now we have to calculate the indicated power, means absorbed power, into multiplication factor gives you the actual power. Then calculate the power factor using a formula. So for making a formula, we need a simple calculations. Okay, fine. Well and good. Now we pass on to the circuit diagram. And this is a given circuit diagram which shows the measurement of basic electrical quantities of voltage, current, power and calculation of a power factor with a given R load. So in the circuit diagram describes you the following things. AC supply of single phase 230 volt is given via the DPSTS. What do you mean by DPSTS? It's a double pole single throw switch. So it's a switch within a single throw, both the points are closed and given supply to the rest of the circuit, and the supply is given to the auto transformer. Now auto transformer, we have two ends. See here, the auto transformer primary is connected to the auto transformer through the variable end. It is given to two knobs, two terminals, means ammeter side and then voltmeter side. So here there is no specification for plus minus because it is an MI meter. So for an MI meter, we have only the phase and then common terminal. Phase and a common terminal. So it is given to the phase. Phase is always represented in a red color, and a common terminal it might have a chance to given with a black color. So it depends. So it is given to the phase of an ammeter. First you have to complete a series connection. So this is a procedure for doing any kinds of an electrical connection. First complete a series connection, then we'll move on to the parallel connection. That is, then only we can understand the closing of a circuit. So from a variable end to ammeter's phase, then common to M of the wattmeter, then L to phase of the load, then neutral of the load is directly connected to the neutral line. Now back to the voltmeter. So one more end from an auto transformer is connected to wattmeter's phase terminal, which may given with a red color or with a range indicated with the particular range, either 300, 150 or 600. Then next terminal, common terminal, is connected to auto transformer. Then auto transformer's end is connected to neutral. Then this is C and M is connected externally with a short wire. Then V connection, V may the 300 volt option. It is connected to the either neutral or to the neutral of the load, so that we could able to complete the circuit. So this is the way we need to connect the circuit. Hope you can clearly understand the connections. With this, we are going to make a connections here. And this is your load. resistive load. See here, these are all the loads. Load number 1, load number 2, 3, 4. Accordingly, we are giving and different loads by simply by switching on. This is an on position. Then upper one is an off position. So gradually we can increase the load simply by switching on the load switch. According to the current rating, the manufacturer specify the current rating of a switch. So up to what extent we are moving for an load, increase in load, up to 10 amps here. And this is a two terminal. Red color represents phase terminal and the black color represents the neutral or a neutral terminal where we are giving an connections. Hope you can easily view the resistive load. The next one is an strange for you is an auto transformer. Now I will show you the auto transformer here. This is an auto transformer. Here we have two terminals, phase, neutral. So from a supply we are giving a phase here and closing a circuit using a neutral here. And this is a very important part we need to note is a white color mark. This is a zero initial position. Gradually by tracking or rotating this knob, we could be able to vary the voltage ranging from 0 to 300 here. For example, if we want to get it over and 230 volt to 230 volt is available here. So while by rotating this knob and by setting and 230 volt, we could easily vary minimum voltage to the rated voltage. And this is a voltmeter where we have common terminal or a neutral terminal, and we have two options of 300 volt and 600 volt. According to the circuit requirement, we are using 300 volt here. And an ammeter. See how you can easily identify the meter given is a moving ion meter that is given here with a sinusoidal symbol, no? Which represents it's an MI meter, moving ion meter. This is a scale where we can read the 600 volt reading, and this is a scale where we could read a 300 volt. And next ammeter. So this is an option of an ammeter where the moving ion meter is given, and here we have a various option. It's a common terminal for neutral and various options are given here, but as far as our requirement, we are in need of a 10 amps meter. And a wattmeter. See, the wattmeter is already well known by us how far to give one wattmeter connection. In a wattmeter connections, if you need a better understanding, description box give you the separate video link for wattmeter connection. Kindly be referred the same and get back to this experiment. So the only connections what we are giving here is an externally is M and common. We have three options over here. So 600 volt, 300 volt and then 150 volt. Our option is to 300 volt connection, and no need to make any of the adjustments here. According to the current rating, manufacturers deals with the connectivity. We just adjust the connectivity. If you are set right in a position, then no need to worry about the extra external connectivities during an experiment. And this is an L terminal. So with this introductory part, I am moving on to your connectivity diagram. Now clearly observe all the wattmeter, ammeter, voltmeter, auto transformer and your resistors connectivity. Now we'll move on to the connectivities from a circuit side. Well students, hope you can understand clearly. We'll move on to the circuit diagram side. So the phase and neutral. Phase we can represent with a red color for a better understanding. Phase and then neutral supply were given, taken from here. So let it be phase. And here is a neutral. For a better understanding, we can make a neutral with a black color. First, move on to the phase connection. See here, phase to auto transformer. So phase terminal is given to the auto transformer phase. Then auto transformer phase, here we have two connections, one to ammeter. So first we will see the ammeter connection. So phase two, we need to give to the ammeter terminal. So it is we'll see from phase 2 ammeters range 10 amps. Then see here, from ammeter common to M. So ammeters common to the M terminal. Then see here, L to load, from L to load phase. Then in a circuit diagram, see clearly, neutral is given to, neutral of the load given to supply neutral. So we'll get an black color for better understanding. Load neutral and then supply neutral were connected. Then we need to give an voltmeter connections. So in a voltmeter, see here, voltmeter's common terminal is connected to the neutral. So first we are giving this supply, and here, so voltmeter's common terminal is connected to auto transformer. See here, auto transformer. For a better understanding, I am clearly explain you again what voltmeter's negative means a common, and wattmeter's common from an voltage, and an auto transformer's common terminal, all are connected to the neutral. So the common of an voltmeter common is connected to auto transformer, or you can easily make the connections like this. Auto transformer's neutral, then voltmeter's neutral or common connection, and the voltage range means 300 of an wattmeter, all are connected. See, one connection, two connection, and three connections. 1, 2, 3 all are given. And one more thing we need to impose here is an connectivity of M and C, external connection. M and C are externally connected by shorting and wire here. So like this, we have to give one single phase 230 volt supply, 50 hertz supply. So what is the procedure? File with a no load condition, given supply is given, slowly rotate the auto transformer up to the 230 volt. Now observe ammeter, voltmeter and wattmeter readings. So in a wattmeter reading, observed reading and the multiplication factor also we need to find. How to find the multiplication factor of the wattmeter? That we can refer the manufacturer's specifications. In the manufacturer specifications, if we are adopting 300 volt 10 amps, the multiplication factor is 4. So it's an important thing, the multiplication for the given wattmeter is 4. Now pass on to the connectivity. So slowly by varying, all the readings were noted under no load. Now just switch on one load and observe voltmeter, wattmeter, ammeter readings. Then switch on second load. So during a first load, it should be 230 volt, no load condition, 0 amps, watts also 0. While if you are increasing and load, the voltage drops, decreases slowly by 1 volt to 1 volt like that. But the current increases. And the power also increases. Current increases, power increases from an initial condition of 230 volt to 00. Then up to what reading we are giving an increasing and load? The load should be increased up to the circuit rated current of 10 amps. So up to 10 amps we need to take an reading. Voltage decreases, current increases, then absorbed readings also increases. Now we'll see you the tabular column and the calculation part. So we'll observe the multiplication factor is 4, and first we are giving and reading first reading with no load condition. So the rated voltage appear across the voltmeter with no load, so no current consumption, zero current, then wattmeter also in a null position or zero position. Then after increasing and load, the second reading your voltage drops, for example 228, but the current increases, let it be increase in current of 1 amps, and then amount of wattmeter, let it be some 50 watts. Then during a third load, again an voltage drops, the current increases, wattmeter also gives an increasing value. Again increasing on load, voltage drops some extent, then your current increases, then watts absorbed also increases. Again increasing on load, up to what extent? Whenever your reading goes up to 10. Up to 10 means you can make it within a 10. 340, then next increase in voltage, then current increases 10 amps. So for a safer purpose, we not even move up to the 10 amps, we can restrict up to 8. So before 10 we restrict. For example, the wattmeter reads 445. So what should be the multiplication factor here? What is an actual reading? Actual reading is absorbed reading into multiplication 4. So here it reads 0, 200, 460, 920, 1360. Simply with multiplying with the multiplication factor 4. Then need to calculate apparent power. What is apparent power? Apparent power is the multiplication of V into I. This in formula, actual power is multiplication factor into absorbed value. Then apparent power is V into I watts. Then power factor is actual power divided by apparent power. Well students, while by observing the formula, the apparent power is V into I. So while making a multiplication, we will get these values, and then power factor is an actual power divided by apparent power. So for reading number 3, I am making a model calculation. For a record purpose, you have to make calculation like this. So as far as our observation concern, we are connecting a resistive load. Resistive load always have an unity power factor. While by absorbing these readings, we are getting nearer to 1 and 1.01, 1.02, it's approximately equal to 1. So we attain the objective. That's why you have to write your result. All the voltage, ammeter, wattmeter readings were observed. From these readings, power, actual and apparent power were calculated using a formula, and power factor is found to be nearest to unity. So according to the given connection of a resistive load, we attain that task. Hope students, you can understand this experiment, and thanks for watching.